What's up, guys? Today's junk, we're going to be looking at a Billy Goat lawn vac that I just picked up for the landscaping business, and we're going to be installing a shredding kit. Now, this is an older model. It's I'm not even sure what year it's from, but I picked it up from Craigslist used for just $300 and seems to be in great shape. I'm going to take you out, show you the machine itself, and show you the part number for the shredding kit that I have to use because of the old model. And yeah, I'll give you a quick rundown, and then we'll get to installing the kit itself. So I put a picture or two of this thing up on Instagram at Getting Junk Done a few days ago, and a couple people commented. So far, this thing has been great, and like I said, Craigslist, $300. And there is the info plate, in case you're curious, with the model number and what have you. So this thing is self-propelled. It has an option for a hose that can be added in this area here. You take this plate off, you put the hose. Hose wraps around in this way, up over that bracket, and in the end sits on this upside down cup holder thing that somebody was using duct tape. Anyway, having said that, the only real issue I've had with this is this handle up here is used to raise and lower the nozzle height, and that cable goes all the way down in this area, and then each hole represents a different height, and it's got a pin in there with a spring, and you pull that up, put it in a different hole, therefore different height. The problem I had was that this knob, this end, was just falling off. You would go put tension on it, you would pull on it, and it pops right off. So what I did was I epoxied, using a two-part epoxy just from Home Depot. I put that back on there, let it sit overnight, and now it's not going anywhere. I also lubricated the cable to prevent any binding, and I lubricated this area here, the spring, and that plate with the holes, and it seems to be working perfectly now. So no more problems raising and lowering the height, and besides that, this machine's been flawless so far. So the reason why I got this machine was because I don't have a giant mower. I have a 33 inch Cub Cadet wide area mower. It's not a zero turn. I don't have a giant bagging system or anything like that, and leaf season is coming up soon. Leaves already started falling, to be honest with you. So I got this machine to help out with leaf removal jobs for people's backyards, primarily gated backyards, where if I did have a large machine, I wouldn't be able to get it back there anyway. So I'm trying to think ahead and trying to plan for the future growth of the business and still get the jobs done now with equipment that I can acquire quite affordably. So $300, this seems to be doing a good job. And I've also started using it along the street next to the curb. After I blow a lot of leaves and stuff in the street from mowing their lawn, I can just run this one pass right down the edge of the curb, and it picks up all the junk, clippings, leaves, weeds that I've cut down using the weed whacker. You get the idea. And then it sits in the bag, and I can usually go, doing that alone, I can usually go probably 5 or 6 lawns before the bag starts to get full. And then the area I work in, most of the properties are in a certain town that has each house has a can dedicated to yard waste. So I just pull out their can from the side of the house, dump my bag in there, put it on the curb for them, done. And it's been working out great so far. So I'm very happy with this purchase. Now let's take a look at the shredding kit. There's gonna be some drilling involved, and I haven't even actually read the instructions yet, so we're gonna do that all together. So here's the kit that came in the mail, and I got it from, I think it was eBay. I order so much online, who knows where I get this stuff from. But I'll put a link down below of kits that I can find. And I got this part number from this one there, from the manual that was available online, PDF, for the model number of this vac. So hopefully this fits. It's direct info from Billy Goat. And here's everything that came in the box itself. You got a Ziploc bag with a sticker and some instructions. The sticker will help out with where to drill, and a couple of bits, and there's the kit itself. So I'm hoping that this is a quick release where I can take it on and off very easily and not have any tools involved. I'm hopeful because these knobs here, you don't need tools to take them off. So what I'm hoping is this just slides in and out, and we're good to go. So let's see what we can do. So I'm looking at the instructions, and this is definitely a new old stock kit. So those are the instructions there. But everything I need is going to be on this set of stickers. So one gets affixed to the machine as a template for where to drill depending on which model you have.
And I'm just going to probably just leave that right on the machine. So we'll see what happens. I'll take care of it and get back to you. But this seems pretty self-explanatory once you're looking at the instructions. All right, so we're at the back of the machine. This is where all the debris comes into the bag. And I just remove the bag. All this does is slide right up. And there's a groove here, right, that kind of just slides in. This plate, this cover slides up, allowing for the bag. So the sticker goes in this place, and then you're gonna follow the directions here, center punch, and then drill some 3/8 holes. Got the holes drilled, not exactly where I wanted them, but this should work. Install the plate from the inside there, and it just slides through, okay? Then there's also it's called a backup plate that will come into this area, and then you put your knobs here. So this does look like a quick release, quick remove kind of thing. And the bag itself, according to what I've looked at here, should slide right over that plate, connect in its normal position, and this is going to be shredding leaves pretty good for me. So it's never as easy as you first expect. So I found after I had this plate installed, it was sticking out in this direction towards the bag itself. The bag has this molded plastic piece that kind of acts as a guide for the leaves. So the leaves come in this end and then shoot and then kind of swirl around that curve into the bag itself. I could not reinstall the bag with the shredder kit installed. So I'm gonna have to do it the other way. I removed the molded piece of plastic from the bag itself. I'm gonna put that on and then slide the shredder kit inside there and just make sure you do this first because you're gonna struggle with it. The nature of how this is installed, it has to slide down like that along those grooves that we mentioned earlier. And you can't do that with the shredder kit installed because there's a bottom on this thing. So I think you get the idea. Let's put this on, I'll put the kit on, and then I'll put the bag on. All right, here's what it looks like after I get it all in. You got your backup plate, they call it, as part of the kit. It's just that flat stock, you see, it's got two holes in it, and that's supposed to, I guess, help distribute the load so you're not pinching any metal. And you get the idea. That sticker's staying there forever. I'm not even bothering. The shredding kit comes out like this as part of the exit from the machine. All the debris has to go through here. Now, this kit specifically says that it's only for dry leaves. So I'm not gonna do pine cones or anything like that. This is specifically for leaf season to help pull things out of the lawn. And I'm assuming you could probably still do like acorns and stuff like that, but we'll see. We're gonna reattach the bag and wrap up this video. All right, that's that. We're all back in business and ready to roll. I gotta load up and start getting some lawns today. So, yep, that's where we're at now.
All right, so if you have an older billy goat with that same model, it's a KD series, whatever that means, then you're gonna wanna get this shredding kit, primarily because dry leaves do get shredded up slightly from the impeller itself, but this is supposed to increase the compaction to a 12-to-1 reduction ratio. If you have any idea what I'm talking about, you probably are already thinking about a machine like this anyway. It's supposed to reduce the number of leaves from 12 bags to 1. So that will highly, highly increase my productivity, especially when I'm in the backyard of a property and I'm gonna be putting the leaves at the curb. This will save me so many trips, roughly 11 trips or so, if my math is right, but you get the idea. So anyway, the biggest problem I had with this installation is that the shredding kit goes on just fine, but I realized after the fact that that nozzle, the molded piece of plastic, must go on first. Well, if you put that molded piece of plastic on first, the shredding kit actually has a hard time fitting in there and you have to muscle it. So get your curses ready to install this. It's not a hard job. I needed a drill. That's it. And I needed a 3/8 inch drill bit. I didn't have one, so you just used a step bit, and it went right through that thin gauge metal of the housing, and it worked out fine. So I'm going to be using this on the job site probably later today, if not soon, when leaves really start coming down, and I'll give a full-blown review of this used Billy Goat KD series lawn vacuum with hose attachment. What am I trying to say? I'm gonna make a review of this thing later on once I get some hours behind it. I've used it for a little while in small jobs and it seems to be working great. It's really awesome at picking things up off the pavement. As far as using it on the lawn and the grass itself, time will tell. So, anyway, if you liked this video, please click like, comment, share, and subscribe. As always, I can be found on Twitter and Instagram at Getting Junk Done. Thanks for watching.